and swatch first impression kind of video on the new Tartlet palette by Tarte. And this is what it looks like right here. I love the purple packaging. But first, I just want to say I have some sad news. I was doing my makeup before I went to sit down to film today, and I wanted to wear my Happy Booster Blush by Physicians Formula. Such sad news. It broke. And I'm like really, really upset, and like I kind of want to just like leave it out. It just completely shattered all over my floor. And I am taking a moment of silence for this, and I need to go buy a new one. So I'm so sad. Well, anyway, enough me being silly. This video is going to be about the new Tartlet palette by Tarte. I'm not exactly sure if this is limited edition or not. We still have it on display on in the Sephora Tarte gondola. We call the displays gondolas. I have no idea why, but it's still there. And I was walking past it the other day while I was facing or laboing, what they call it, like just making sure everything's like neat and tidy. And I saw we had like one left, so I put it on hold. To make a long story short, I got my hands on it, and I'm so happy I did. This retails for $44, so not terribly, you know, insanely too bad. I mean, you do get 4, 8, 12, 12 eyeshadows for $44, and I think that's a really good deal. So let's just get into the palette. So right off the bat, the packaging is absolutely gorgeous. I love how they did the gradient effect with like a light purple to a darker purple with the gold lettering Tarte right here, and an all gold type of packaging. The only thing is that it does get kind of worn after a while. Like you can see my fingerprints after a while, but that's just a quick rub down. I know a lot of women really don't like that, but it's whatever. It has a nice big mirror, so, and these are pretty much all of the colors. I love how they're pretty much all matte. There's no shimmer, no shine, no nothing, so it's very wearable. Of course, if you wanted to work in a shimmer, you can definitely, you know, find another eyeshadow to work into it. Sorry if I'm blinding you. So that's pretty much the packaging, and let's just get on to the colors. So how this palette works, you have all matte shadows, like I said. They also have the Tarte emblem, like the letter embedded, whatever the word is, actually in the shadow. So I do like when companies do that. I don't know, it just adds a little extraness to the palette itself. And what's cool about this, I actually just noticed, you see how it's like a gradient effect on the packaging? It kind of like works into the actual shadows. So you have lightest to darkest. So I kind of like how they did all that. Browns on this top row. You have all purples. And like just some more neutral colors. I like how they added a gray color in there. So the first color we see here is called Free Spirit. And it kind of reminds me like a really nice like vanilla type of color. And it goes on really nice and smooth. So that's it right here. The next color we have is called Force of Nature. And I don't know if you're going to be able to see it, but that is it right here. It's a really, really, really light brown caramel color almost. It's not insanely pigmented, but it is really nice for the crease area. I find for more maybe like lighter skin tones, but on me it kind of doesn't show up, but I could definitely work with it. The next color we have is called Dreamer, and this is a beautiful brown color, very, very pigmented. That's it right here. It is a gorgeous earthy brown color, very, very wearable. I love brown colors, so neutral. You could definitely see how pigmented that guy is. And then the last color of that row is called Multitasker, and that is it right here. So you can see it's a little bit darker than the Dreamer color, so I feel like all three of these colors will be a beautiful smoky brown eyeshadow, and yeah, I love brown shadows. So again, we have free spirit, I don't know if you'll be able to see it, free spirit, force of nature, dreamer, and multitasker. And those are the top row of the palette. So the second row that we have are all the purple tone eyeshadows, and the first one is called Caregiver, and this is a really nice pastel light pink. Again, pastel colors don't really show up on my skin tone, so I'm not really sure if you're going to be able to see it, but that is Caregiver. I kind of like swatched it in the middle. I probably should have moved it over. But I really do like this color though. I kind of like how, for some reason, I think of like breast cancer awareness because of the pink and then the name of the color. But I really, really love this color. Again, pastel colors really don't show up on my very harsh olive skin tone, so you probably might not be able to see it. That's Caregiver. These next three shadows that I'm going to mention, I'm actually wearing all over my lids today. And this one is called Natural Beauty. And this one is a really nice dusty mauve rose type of color. That's it right here. Really easy to blend. It could be more pigmented, but I like how it is kind of is, but I love this color. Very, very pretty. And again, that is Natural Beauty. This next color is called Best Friend, and this one is just a little bit darker. I have this on my outer corner today, and this again is a little bit darker than the Natural Beauty, but all in that same purple, cooler tone, purple family, and I love that one. That is a beautiful, gorgeous, very blendable eyeshadow. Last one of the purple row is called Bombshell, and I'm actually going to put this here. This is the darkest one of the purple row, and that is freaking gorgeous. I love a good blendable purple. It's almost kind of like borderlining a dark purple gray. There's a little bit of gray in there, but it's very richly pigmented, and I have this again in my outer corner today, if you could see that, and I love these purple shadows. And I was actually wondering what I wanted to put on my lips, so if you guys are wondering what to pair the purple with what I have on today, I actually have on a NYX lip liner pencil in the color Sand Pink, and on my lips I have the Lorac, it says highly pigmented cream lipstick in the color Goddess. So that is the pairing that I did with my lips with these types of purple cooler tone shadows. So just curious about that. I'll link everything down below in the description box, so just in case if you're curious. So again, with the purple row of this palette, the lightest one, Caregiver, Natural Beauty, Best Friend, and Bombshell. And then again, that's the purple tones of the palette. So the last row, I find that the last row of this palette is kind of random because there isn't really like a cohesiveness to this row. But anyway, the first one of the last row is called Super Mom. And again, pastel light colors do not show up on me, but I did use this on my brow bone today. I don't think you're able to see it, but I did, where did I even put it? I put it like right here. You are not going to be able to see it on my skin tone, but that is it right here. Really kind of just blends away. That's kind of like the only dud I feel in the palette, but yeah, you're not going to be able to see that. But anyway, that's called Super Mom. Super Mom, you could be more super. The next color that I have is called Wanderer, and this is what actually I have in my crease today with the other purple shadows that I mentioned, and that is right here. I find that this is more of a true camel type of color, like a brown leather couch for some very strange reason. That's how I think, but that is it right here. Very nicely pigmented. It's a nice cooler toned brown, and I really do appreciate that. I mean, I really don't have a lot of cooler tone browns in my collection. A lot of my browns are warm, so I did appreciate that they put a cooler tone brown in the palette, but I love this color. Very richly nice and pigmented. Very easy to blend. I love that one. The next shade is called Power Play, and this is a really nice gray color. I love a good gray. The only thing with this, I wish it was just a little bit more pigmented. It's very softly pigmented. However, you can build this up little by little. I'm sorry if I'm not flicking you guys off. I just find it easier to swatch with my middle finger. But I find that this one could be just a little bit more pigmented. It's like a gray purple-ish. But regardless, I still think it's a nice color. So that, again, is Power Play, and that's it right there. So the last color I have is the darkest shade, and that is called Fashionista. And this is just a gorgeous, amazing black color. That is it right here. I mean, it's like one of those blacks that needs no introduction, I feel like. So that again is Fashionista, and I love this color. This would be a gorgeous black for a regular traditional black smoky eye. And so those are pretty much all of the colors of the last row. You definitely can't even see Supermom anymore, but that other one was Supermom. Again, this one is Wanderer, Power Play, and Fashionista. So that is the last row of that palette. One thing that I wanted to mention as I was swatching these, I find that when I was doing it with my finger, my hands are like all dirty, so please excuse that. I find that the actual name, the Tarte word, was kind of like rubbing off. I don't know if you'll be able to notice, but that's just one thing that I wanted to point out. However, I really feel like this is an all-over great palette. I would give this a B+ in my book. If we were doing from like grading, like in school, A through D, I would give this a B+. I feel like they could be just a little bit more pigmented. As I was personally doing my eyeshadow look today, like I mentioned, I have Natural Beauty, Best Friend, and Bombshell on all of my eyes today. I find that I had to really work to get the pigmentation that I wanted. And for a matte color like these guys, you really can't, you know, mess around with the shadows and like wet your brush and do all that with satin colors. Yes, you can do that, but with matte colors, you really can't do that. But I mean, regardless, I did like what I came up with today. If you guys want to see a tutorial on this, please give this video a thumbs up and I'll definitely make one, or just comment down below. Or if you want to see like another look, maybe I'll do like a brown smoky eye with these guys here. So just let me know in the comments down below. But again, I definitely give this palette a B+. Definitely gonna have to play around with it. I'm really super happy that I do have it in my collection. I know everyone's opinions are different. Some girls that I talk to at work aren't really a fan of it. Some are. So it is kind of like a mixed review. Me personally, I really do like it. Just, I wish they were just a little bit more pigmented. That is my review and swatches of the Tarte Lip palette. I hope you guys enjoy watching these types of videos, little quick mini reviews and stuff like that. I hope you guys take a moment to subscribe. It would definitely make my day and help me out. Please like this video if you obviously enjoyed watching it. And comment down below letting me know, again, if you want to see a tutorial or any other video suggestions. I love always reading comments and would love to have more interaction with my viewers. So that is pretty much all I have for today. Hope you guys have a great week, day, whatever. I don't even know anymore. Have a great day. Bye.